evening, and welcome to Bethel University and Benson Great Hall. My name is Dr. Maren Geisegill, and I am the Director of Choral Activities and Chair of the Department of Music and Performing Arts. I have the great pleasure to welcome you to the Lucia Chorum and Royal Register Spring Concert, directed by my wonderful colleagues, Professors Brad Beal and Nicole Lambrecht. We invite you to all of our upcoming concerts this spring. You can see a list of many of these performances on the back of your program. I'd like to highlight April 12th, the Chamber Orchestra Home Concert. Starting April 18th and running through the 28th, our Black Box Theater will be the host for our spring play, a delightful murder mystery comedy called The Plot Like Gravy Thickens by Billy St. John and directed by Summer Shop. The play has been described as a murder mystery comedy with audience interaction, some storm effects, spiffy costumes, and lots of other good stuff. It's very funny, it's very talented people involved. We'd especially like to invite you to come to our culminating departmental concert on Friday, May 10th, entitled Classics in the Great Hall, featuring the Bethel Wind Symphony, Concerto Aria Contest winners, of which there are three, and Mozart's well-known and beloved Requiem. On the back of your program, you'll see a QR code to our event website and brochure that has descriptions of all our concerts. Tickets for all of our events are available at tickets.bethel.edu. There's also another QR code on the back of the program. You can scan that and give to support our music students, scholarships, and department. Grateful to you for your support by attending our performances, and we covet your prayers for the future of our department. At this moment, I'd like to pray. Thank you, God, for the gift of song, for the gift of your word, and for the gift of the ability to share that word with our souls and with each other. Lord, we thank you for these students, for their directors, and for this time, and just ask that you bless it, bless their performances, and our ability to hear the messages that you've placed in this music and in your children. In Christ's name, amen.
Thank you. Welcome to our concert, Singing Through the Storm. Life can throw us many challenges, but also endless moments to celebrate. The two pieces you just heard share the initial calling out for help and the feelings of loneliness that they can sometimes come with a struggle. But they also express the celebration of pure joy and transformation that life can bring for us during those moments of turmoil or strife.
Our next selection, Where Can I Turn for Peace, provides us with the reassurance that no matter where we are going in our lives, God and his endless love remain steadfast and true. Following that, we will perform an arrangement of Ruth Moody's Storm Comin', which encourages us to avoid running for cover from the storm, but rather teaches us to embrace the storms in our lives to help us learn and grow as Christians and humans.
Thank you. Gwyneth Walker's arrangement of the traditional spiritual Steal Away to Jesus. It is a song of alternating sorrow and strength. Walker set the text to descend in certain areas to represent falling tears and to rise at other spots, representing the soul ascending to heaven.
Hello, everyone. My name is Nicole Lambrecht, and I have had the privilege of conducting Lucia Quorum here at Bethel for the past 3 years. And it's so fulfilling to see my students grow, not only as musicians and singers, but as young women. And I get the privilege of introducing one of these fantastic young women, Elizabeth Gerken, who is a music composition major here, who came to me last spring with an idea to compose a piece for Lucia, and of course, I was all for it. So her next song, called I Will Stand, which you are about to hear, was composed by her and also features an original poem as the text setting. Additionally, Elizabeth has taught this piece from the very first notes, and she will be conducting this song this evening as well. So here she is to speak a little bit about it.
Good evening. Good evening, everyone. I hope you are all doing well and enjoying yourselves so far. I was convicted to compose a piece about standing up for your family, freedom, and friends, even when all you have left are the very breath that you have in your lungs. If you have your breath, that is enough to have the will to survive and to thrive. The words of the chorus are, "Wherever you throw me, I'll stand. The wind may toss me, but I will always land. With my feet on the ground, there is no turning back. Wherever you throw me, I'll stand." These words come from the national motto of the Isle of Man, which is a small island country in the UK, where I actually have some ancestors. I have always been intrigued by Celtic music and wanted to explore and attempt to embody their music through this piece with my own personal spin. What helps you through hard times is knowing your past, living in your present, and embracing your future. You're not the product of your past mistakes. You are the everyday choice to stand up for yourself and community. We succeed through community, and we succeed through knowing that even when we feel alone, God will comfort us and guide us along the path He has prepared for us. Will you choose to stand?
Thank you. All right. Hello. My name is Brad Beal, and I direct the Royal Register here at Bethel, and who you see coming up to join me right behind me. Thank you, boys. The first of our two combined numbers is O Love by Elaine Hagenberg. It's been a joy to prepare these pieces and allow our singers to collaborate with one another and incorporate the ideas of a different conductor in their music making. O Love is a wonderful piece that explores the depth of God's love for us, that he will be there through all of life's trials. The text focuses on the trust that we put in him and how that trust is rewarded with his love. Please enjoy Lucia Coram and the Royal Register singing O Love.
Thank you.
Thank you. As Lucia makes their way off the stage, I'll walk you through the first few songs of the Royal Register's set. We will start with Do You Fear the Wind, a puffed-up song that encourages men to be unafraid of the storms of life and walk like a man. That is then followed by Bend in the Storm, a spiritual arrangement by the Minnesota-based lower voice ensemble Cantus. Contrasting the brash nature of Do You Fear the Force of the Wind, this song focuses on the reality that we will encounter storms in our lives. As men, it can be easy to think that the answer is always to push ahead, but Bend in the Storm reminds us that prayer and trust in God can see us through. After that is Himina Morviana, or The Mist-Covered Mountains of Home. Written by Scottish Highlander John Cameron as a longing for his homeland, it resonates with warmth as we visualize the comfort of home, the places, the people, and the support found there. Next is the familiar hymn, It Is Well With My Soul. Our journey turns a corner with this triumphant tune as we continue to recognize that our faith in God is the most solid foundation that we could have. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
Me too, to be honest. Woo. All right, our set finishes with Sing Your Way Home, Will the Circle Be Unbroken, and the Royal Parting Blessing. Sing Your Way Home encourage us to use the gift of song to find comfort, a call back to the warmth that we long for in Himina Morviana. That is followed by Will the Circle Be Unbroken, a tune that reminds us that regardless of the valleys of life, there is still a better home waiting for us in heaven. We'll then end our set with the Royal Parting Blessing, a song that traditionally ends every Royal Register rehearsal. We hope you enjoy the second half of our set.
The song was written by a previous conductor, and it started out as a prayer, and then gradually grew into a song. But it still holds that same principle when it was a prayer that God will watch over us, that God will provide for us and deliver us from all the trials in our lives. It also highlights the importance of community and the brotherhood that is shared in this group. As some of us are singing this song for the last time as students, it gives me great peace to know that this song will continue to be sung, that prayers will continue to be answered, that faith will continue to grow and flourish, and that stories will continue to be told. I didn't see any past Reggies out there when I was looking earlier, but if there are any Reggies out there in the crowd, we would like to invite them up to join us in the royal parting blessing at this time.
Hello, everyone, again. I hope you have enjoyed this evening of beautiful music. It's such a joy to be able to share this concert with the Reggies. Can we give both of our groups one more round of applause, please? Our final combined piece, You Are the Music, speaks to the true element of music making, being human. The opening text reads, "'Tis you that are the music, not your song. Your song is but a door which, opening wide, lets forth the pent-up melody inside, your spirit's harmony, which pure and strong sings but of you." Without the individual melodies of every single one of these students, without their God-given talents and emotional performances, the music would fall flat. Music, and especially performing in ensembles, provides a unique ephemeral experience, something that we can't often put into words or really capture the true meaning of it. Dan Forrest sets this incredible text to music and provides us with the soundscape of the various cadences with which we can arrive in at life, all of them teaching us something and giving us comfort, even amidst the storm. Thank you again for attending this evening, and I hope one of these pieces really spoke to your heart and moved you in ways that we were hoping for. Please enjoy our final piece, You Are the Music.
Thank you. Thank you.